Patricia, how are you?
I'm good. How are you?
Good.
Did you enjoy the movie?
I did. You know, I felt so embarrassed because I was very emotional.
Oh, you were.
And they were like trying to get my reaction to the film, and I'm like, I'm just so emotional.
Good.
It's the star for me is so symbolic because it's really a story about triumph and getting through things and what is it that gets you motivated. And for some reason, it made me really emotional.
Well, it's about hope. It's about forgiveness. It's about working together. We need all those sentiments this holiday as we struggle through difficult times. So I think it's going to be a welcome addition this year, and I think it's going to become a classic for every year to come.
Yeah, I said that. I was like, it's been a rough year. So watching this film was also, it brought out a lot of emotion.
Yes, and what's nice about it, it has humor in it.
Yes.
It has physical comedy in it. Having the nativity story told from the perspective of the animals just makes it very fresh. Mary and Joseph are really humanized. We were reminded how young they were and that they were just people. And they were sort of the center of the greatest story ever told. So I think they've done a wonderful job in the star of bringing all those things out.
Now, do you think when kids... We, of course, fully understand the storyline and what this is about. Do you think kids will comprehend that and understand? There were a few kids where when we were watching it, I'm like, I wonder if they really get it.
Mm. I guess if you're being raised in a Christian household, you'll really get it, obviously. And for kids that aren't, I think it's a nice way for them to be introduced to the story of the birth of Jesus.
Yes, beautiful.
Yeah.
And now you've had a lot of longevity just in this business.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm curious, what would be symbolic for you in your life for the star? Like, what's kept you motivated and in this industry for so long?
Well, I really feel like I know for sure, actually, that all the opportunities that were presented to me, it was God's timing because it didn't happen when I wanted it to happen. I didn't start making my living as an actor until I was like 30.
Oh,
but it became clear that God was opening the doors that he wanted to open. And I'm so glad that he did. And I'm very grateful for his timing because I was able to establish my family first and be grounded in my family. That way, the ups and downs of the entertainment business did not impact me so much because I knew that the most important thing was my family. And to be able to go to work every day and come home every night to my husband and my kids was also really important. And so for me, you know, to be able to be a part of this story and hopefully like sort of give back a little bit and celebrate the birth of Christ because, you know, all that he has done for me, I feel like I'm grateful to be a part of this project because of that.
That's so beautiful. Mm. And such a needed, I needed that message today. So
yes.
thank you.
Oh, let me tell you, just be faithful and wait.
And we all needed it.
Yeah.
Now just, you know, I'm curious, last question about, can you tell us a little bit about behind the scenes? So are you actually in a room with some of the other voice actors?
No, it's a little bit weird voice acting because you're by yourself with the director and the sound engineer. Mm. And he's, you know, you're hoping you're doing as well as everybody else is doing. But I've only seen Zach and Gina Rodriguez just now before this interview. And Kristen Chenoweth wasn't able to make it today. But I haven't seen anybody. I haven't seen Oprah Winfrey since we did the finale of Everybody Loves Raymond and we were on her show, which was like 20 years ago.
Wow. Well, Oprah, you're welcome to come by.
Yeah, we're waiting for you, Oprah.
Yes. Thank you so much,
Patricia.
Pleasure meeting you.
Thank you so much.